Well, the story of how African slaves got to the Caribbean paradoxically begins in Britain, with Britain's expansion as a commercial power in the 17th, 18th centuries. And the triangle of trade was really took goods from Britain to exchange for slaves on the West African coast. And the slaves were then herded into ships and transported across the Atlantic in that terrible middle passage, sold into slavery in the Americas. And then the third leg of that trade brought the product of slave labor in the Americas, rum and tobacco and molasses and cotton, back to British society. Cities like Bristol and Liverpool and so on.
Spaniards, the Maroons, they were the slaves of the Spaniards, and they went into the bushes. And from that time, they started to demonstrate their skill regarding the knowledge of the woods and also survival. And Nanny, the great chieftainess, the greatest of all our leaders, she made her fortress up on the Blue Mountains, and she clothed her soldiers in the leaves and branches of trees. And this thing was done so realistically that when the British came, these trees would move, encircling the British army. The end result was that the Maroons were completely victorious. In fact, the English themselves, the British, approached the Maroons and begged for peace. It was a wise thing, of course, because the island became a better place to live in.
Well, the word Maroons really comes from a Spanish word, cimarron, meaning a runaway slave. And marinage, the communities of runaway slaves, was really common throughout all slave society. And these Maroon communities provided the best conditions for the survival of traditional African customs and practices in the Caribbean.
Because we are a set of people who like to express ourselves in dancing, then we must have the music in order to dance. Music plays such a part that it is an all-pervading part, and I think that helps to make one a little stronger than he would have been otherwise. these customs and so forth were brought directly from Africa and were preserved. In the area that is now Ghana, that time it was the Gold Coast. You see, the majority of our forefathers came from that section of Africa, the Ashantis. Suppose we are having a celebration. See, it is joy, it is merriment, and we sing those songs, and we're happy, and we try to make others happy too. And then to think of the spirits, and to get in touch with them, the music had to be used.
Years. After 1807, a truly indigenous form developed, or got a chance to develop. But up to that time, there were waves of new African migrations of slaves into the territory. By the 19th century, the Europeans were going further down the African coast. And many of the slavers which were caught in the high seas had slaves who were coming from what we now know as the Congo. Came to Jamaica after 1838 as indentured laborers, and one tradition has it that the Kumina religious cult came in at that time, and hence the recency and the durability of the deep Africanity, if you like, of that particular ritual.
Yeah. born in St. Thomas here, and my father is from St. Elizabeth. So I am from an African and a Maroon tribe. We do the communal in helping people when they are sick, that's one. And we do the communal as a pleasure at Christmas time, August, and even at Easter time.
Call a kumina ceremony to invoke the gods for a court case, for blessing in marriage, a number of things, in tombing and whatever. And again, there's a sacrifice, which are good sort of religious practices, you know. We have our sacrifices in Christianity as well. And of course, spirit possession.
Tombing, okay? Someone may be sick and they call for a kumina, then you pray the kumina. We pray kumina sometimes when people die, that we pray kumina.
The black and white kumina is when you have anybody dead and making a prayer for them. Okay, you use the black and white and candle. That's the time you kill the goat.
Presence in the Caribbean and the Americas is a Spanish one, and consequently a Catholic one. It's Catholic Spain that are the first conquistadores of the Americas. And the British slavers and colonizers really come in on the Spanish coattails. I mean, of course, in places like Jamaica, which we now think of as British, were originally Spanish, and the Spanish influence, Spanish Catholic influence, one should say, is still very predominant in islands like Cuba and Puerto Rico, and of course, what we now call the Dominican Republic.
Manifestaciones religiosas les fueron prohibidas. Pero así como ellos lo fueron cristianizando, ellos comenzaron a tocar en las fiestas religiosas católicas y lo que tocaban eran sus motivos religiosos africanos que ellos vestían con la religión católica porque decían que era adorando a los santos y fueron buscando la equivalencia de sus dioses con los santos católicos. Y así su dios de la guerra, su dios del hierro, le pusieron un nombre católico de un santo. Y así nació el sincretismo religioso, que es hoy la parte vital de la religiosidad popular dominicana.
A syncretic culture is really neither the one thing nor the other. It's neither European any longer, nor African, because it's fusing on a third place, in a third area, in the Caribbean, and it's fusing in a slave colony. And so the result is something which owes a great deal to European and African past, but is neither one thing nor the other. It's the fusion and formation of a third distinctive culture, a syncretic culture.
Que ganó su independencia de Haití y no de España. Los primeros 20 años de la República lo pasamos guerreando con intentos de invasión. Y así nació una actitud hostil contra Haití acerca del mal que hacen los haitianos. Ellos trajeron el vudú, ellos trajeron, comen niños, hacen todas las cosas malas, las hacen los haitianos. Y siempre han tratado de dividir nuestros pueblos. Y en la cédula personal de identidad nunca dice una persona que es negra, sino indio oscuro, indio lavado, indio ligero, etc. esa no es la realidad, pero eso es lo que nos han enseñado. Y cada vez que presentamos algo como de origen haitiano, dicen no, solo de origen africano, dicen no, solo trajeron los haitianos y no quieren saber de nada negro en nuestra cultura, porque para el dominicano común nosotros somos un pueblo blanco de Caribe, y por eso hoy hay merengues en Curazao, Venezuela, Colombia, Panamá, Cuba, Puerto Rico y Santo Domingo. Y así mezclamos un nombre y un ritmo, porque el ritmo es totalmente africano, con una forma melódica europea.
Dice San Antonio, aquí mamo yo. Dice San Antonio, aquí mamo yo. Yo soy el patrón de Guarabano.
De muchas cosas diferentes. Mezcla elementos precristianos con música del siglo XII de Inglaterra, música africana, instrumentos africanos, pero la cuerda dorsal del momis es el play, como le llaman ustedes, que se conserva más o menos pura con los caracteres principales de Rey Jorge, el Caballero Turco, Sasanás y otros cuantos personajes que realmente se han conservado a pesar de todas las evoluciones y de todas las influencias que ha tenido que soportar el momis en nuestro país.
Milking pail. When he twin brothers of Assassin's Creed, when our mommy saw him come around, hurrah!
Comenzaron a venir los inmigrantes ingleses de las islas, desde mediados del siglo pasado, cuando comenzó la industria azucarera en nuestro país. La inmigración llegaron a constituir una subcultura, la subcultura cocola, como les llamamos, que ha mantenido vigente los elementos principales de ellos hasta el día de hoy.
Oh, I'm a British. Paid immigration every year. I'm a British. So anytime I want to leave the country, nobody stopped me.
Why is it important to be a British?
Because that's my flag. I love my flag until when I go to the grave. I'm not supposed to sell my British flag. No nation. That's my flag, British flag.
You spoke the English language when you came here?
Yeah, to my English people. You know, the language in the dam is Spanish. But when I met with my English people, well, I speak English. You understand? This country, have a this town here, many years back, it had plenty more English people. But plenty of them gone away and plenty die out. You understand?
I am the king of Egypt. Joseph shall plainly disappear. I come to seek my son, my only son and heir. But he's dead, and that's the worst of it. Whom did I plain? And whom did I plain? Yes, yes, my leader, I will obey. But with my sword, I hope to win the day. With my sword and son, I hope to win the day. So stand forth, brave St. John, Christian, and boldly face I will.
I don't want just...
Turkish knife.
Turkish knife.
Why am the Turkish knife? Just from the Turkish land to fight. I will now take St. David from my foe. And made him kneel before I go. Yes, yes, my league I will obey. For with my sword, I hope to win the day. With my sword and shield, I hope to win the day. Was it?
Catholic tradition, and it's really the celebrations at Easter up to Shrove Tuesday, which precede the long period of fasting and Lent. But I think carnival has a deeper meaning. Wherever you find it, it always includes the idea of a reversal. That's to say, of the time when the oppressed or the poor who don't normally celebrate or are not normally licensed to enjoy and express themselves have a moment when they're permitted to do so, and their masters stand aside and, as it were, watch the slave take over for a moment. And in fact, in Jamaica, the John Canoe processions, which occur at Christmas time, are really Jamaican versions of carnival.
Rock. noticed that in Latin America, they have this yankunu. And we, as children, we call it yankunu. And to me, that similarity is not likely to be just coincidental. Also, the hobby horse is part of yankunu. And the hobby horse, as you know, is something that's in the Indian. We find it in Yugoslavia. We find it in Basque country. And I'm sure there are a lot of other places. So yankunu really is quite a potpourri.
Well, we dance, elephant performance. Say the queen dance softly. You are the devil Satan, you know, just go out. You are the wild Indian, just run in the bush and bawl out, you know. Like that, I say, woo, 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 you know. And then dance around. You have the acid, you have the coed. When they don't get the junk, you know, they're just like somebody out, you know, getting mad. They would like to see it every year. Keep them amusing. But if it's not the junk, you know, they don't know that it's Christmas. See? We know that Christmas is tomorrow. And if the junk, you know, don't come out, you don't see no liveliness. You don't see no crowd.
Time things, you know, you heard of it that it come from some country over foreign, you know, yankunu. But in first days that gone past, yankunu never recognized like now. They walk along the street and play drum and knock on people, ask, tone them and call them dirty yankunu. But now what is hide from the wise and proven revealed to babe and suckling? The yankunu come up to a mark now that he come actually like a person in the church, you know. It's very wonderful because they have to send us telegram now when they want us and bring us to wherever they want and give us the best treatment, and nobody can molest us because we are guarded by police and soldiers on the ground now. So it's a very good thing. Sometimes in 1928, 6th of March, and I started 35 around in 1932. My mother died when I was 4 years old, and a good fife man, I was bawling to go with her. I never realized who was dead. And Ivan gave me the fife named Harold Leach from Jack's River, St. Mary. He said, "Blow, your mother soon come." So when I take the fife, I couldn't turn a tune on, just getting a sound in the fife and forget to cry for my mother until she's buried off, and I always have the fife all day, blowing, 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 so till I could be able to turn a tune. Playing the music, you know. I always love to play a tune that the girls them can hear and look at it. If the tune suit them, you know, they always draw attention towards the yankunu bands and said, "He can play the fife very well because I can play a tune that says to them, said, this tune, the name of this tune is where your wheel and turn, you know. Belly pan tambourine, you know.
Can you sing that song?
Yeah. Where you want wheel and turn me, where you want wheel and turn me, you want me to fall down, lick me belly pan tambourine. Where you want wheel and turn me, where you want wheel and turn me, you want me to fall down, lick me belly pan tambourine.
So on my way to school, they would always be digging up the streets of Kingston, it seemed to me when I was a child, and they were singing these digging songs, you know? Judy drowned, why, oh, Judy drowned. And they come down to it's line on chorus, you know, and they always have a singer man who raises the tune. You know, they had to pay a man to sing separately, you know. The government in those days, when they were digging the streets, and the singer man would say, would raise the tune, man, and he says, Judy drowned, everybody come down, why, oh, Judy drowned, why, oh, Judy not drowned, Judy in a bed, Judy body ball, oh, Judy drowned, Judy not dead, but Judy drowned, why, oh, Judy drowned, and this, you know, so you'd listen to this, oh, boy. And then one of the first ones that I used to hear, and this was very popular, was Chichibod. Up to today, Chichibod is my favorite Jamaican folk song. And when I go on the stage on, I say, and now I'm going to end by singing my favorite, and everybody said, Chichibod! And that is, Chichibod means a flock of birds. And the singer man calls out the names of the birds, and the diggers, or the chorus, they say, some of them are hala, some are bala. Some are hollering and some are bawling. So this singer man says, ah, Chichibada, some of them are holler, some are bawl. Chichibada, some of them are holler, some are bawl. Some are come long, some of them are holler, some are bawl. Some are blue foot, some of them are holler, some are bawl. Ting, ting, some of them are holler, come are bawl. Ching, ching, some of them are holler, some are bawl, you know. Some are chick man chick and all the different birds, you know. And, I used to love this, you know. Some of them are holler, some are ball. And then at the end he says, some of them, when he's going to, at the end, you know, he generally ends with John Crow, you know, the crow. Some are John Crow, some of them are holler, some are ball.
This fourth beat, to me, is very often accented. You get, Hilangoli rido, Hilangoli, Hilangoli rido, Hilangoli, and you bend down low down, Hilangoli, and the same thing happens in Mento. We get da 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 da, so on, and you know any Mento you take, you'll get that. I'm sure it has some significance. We haven't found out what it is yet.
Doing all my research into Jamaican folklore, and I said to one old gentleman I'm talking to, you know, and I said to him, what you call all the songs? He says, every Jamaica folk song is a mento. Every Jamaica folk song is a mento. We sing mento. So I say, where we get the mento from? He said, we grow it. language, and then the language led you on to the proverbs, the riddles, the stories, the songs. It was not just that people were talking like this because they couldn't do better. It was that they were creating a thing for themselves, something that was better for their personality, you know, to express themselves in a way. And it was a whole creative process. You go to school, and you're taught to read and write in one language. But the language is not the language that you talk normally, or you talk at school. But I should really say before that, you know, because parents are always saying, don't say that, you know, talk right, you know, talk it down. Why don't talk correct? And this sort of thing. And they're always sort of telling you that the bad language, you know, this was bad. But you never paid much attention because they were talking. Sometimes when they were telling you it was a bad language, they were talking in the same language to you, you know. You know, and they pass the stones, and you have to pass them fast. And you finger mash, not cry. You must not, you know, cry if your fingers get mashed. Remember to play with that play. We are playing, we're only playing, you know. In the Mento songs, you find the same rhythm in the Poco songs, in the Rival, in the Reggae. You find that there's the same rhythm of the spoken, the Jamaican language, you know?
Tell me, brother, Dilly Dally. You say we gone down the alley. Don't smoke up the collie. Don't in the kingdom of the heaven after get to where it tell you. Don't in the kingdom of the heaven after get to where it tell you. I say the cats were superstars.
One of the first things that ordinary Jamaicans could do was to either read the Bible or know about certain Bible stories. Now, it's these biblical rhythms, I think, that have really deeply penetrated the vernacular language. And you hear it in the reasoning and prophecy of reggae and reggae lyrics, but you hear it also in ordinary speech of people who in their ordinary talk will suddenly elevate their language and take in what is in fact a key passage from the St. James Bible.
So be wise, therefore, you kings, and be stupid, you fathers, you which have deserved. Certain Lord God, your right to far, I will fear with joy, should tremble. Say, I the son, unless he be younger.
I think reggae is a sort of essential Caribbean form because it's a hybrid form, because you can hear the different influences in it. On the one hand, it comes from that movement, that moment in the 60s, when people discovered the sort of elemental rhythms of Jamaican music. I think that was a moment really of essentially recapturing something deeply African about rhythmic forms in Jamaica.
Africa,
reggae music and its harmonies and its voice production and so on owe a great deal to North American blues, to North American soul music, to gospel music. And both these two traditions fuse in the technology of the new music industry, which explodes in Jamaica in the 60s and 70s. And so it's really the product of Africa on top of America, on top of a modern 20th century musical technology. One of the most interesting things about Caribbean culture is that because its roots are lost somewhere in the past, it has constantly to kind of remake itself. And I think something of the same kind happens when substantial numbers of black people come to Britain and start to make their life there. You get a kind of Jamaican colony beginning to throb at the center of big British cities. And it's at that moment that they hear something in the music, new music coming out of Kingston, that is itself speaking of the oppression of people in Kingston, and they identify with that.
Hard, 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 hard. But it's my time now, I pay the piper, I call the tune. Said it's my time now, I pay the piper, I call the tune.
I think what we see is just simply the next turn of the creative screw, so to speak. I mean, what's happened to music all along in the Caribbean has happened now to Caribbean people in Europe. Thank you.
Descubra el espectáculo de la imaginación con el programa Raíz Rock y Reggae dentro de nuestro tema semanal del Caribe. Al terminar, Salsa Opus Puerto Rico.